It's coming to you. It's coming to you.
So let's have it here.
Sir, it's coming to you.
See?
Oh, I see.
Who can ask? That's the baby.
Amen.
Is there not a difference between fat and lamb?
They're not the same.
No.
The Bible,
see?
Is there not a difference between fat and lamb?
You see?
One of them has a long head, one has a short head because of the alley.
One's fighting.
Yeah,
it's right, but when you read the same.
No. First form and third form are completely different words in Arabic.
The difference is
Arabic proper.
Fat and lamb. Mate, I was so worried,
you know.
Speak Arabic.
No, you see.
Khalil.
It's me.
I'm better at reading.
When they see the Bible, they panic. What's
the name of this Quran?
What is the name of this Quran?
She can read the Quran. She said that the Quran. Read it. Read the Quran. The Bible says three Bibles are not the same. You want to debate? I saw your Bible. Okay, let's debate. Let's debate.
She's scared.
They go to people. Brothers here who are not prepared to debate with them and try to explain. Look at it. But when I come, they pant. She's gonna go.
So listen.
I'm here.
Come on, man.
I got the three Bibles. Contradiction. 120. Not the same. You believe in them?
So go.
She's not gonna answer. You believe in the Bibles?
Debate.
See, answer it. Die. And I don't talk it. But what I'm trying to tell you, you have three Bibles that are not the same. Look at him. Okay, let's debate. You see, say there are three Qurans. You see the liar? I'm ready to expose her. Okay, let's debate then. Let's debate. You see, they panic when they see the Bible. The brother came. She said to the brother that there are three Qurans. What a liar. Come on, let's see. Let's read. Show us three Qurans.
Muslim missionary said
this.
And once, they have not been able to fill the holes.
Okay, I'm here. Can you debate? I show you.
I can't fill the holes.
See, we're talking to the brother. Oh, when I come, they panic, see? Because they don't believe in their Bible. There.
So talk about the Bible. Show him.
Read the Quran and show the difference.
So
three
talk
Bibles
to him.
Here. Three. See, they're not the same. Can I show you? Chopping and changing, not the same. The Quran, 140 surahs, 6,231, 36 verses. Wrong edition, not the edition, not the same. Yeah, not the same. Yeah. You see how crafty they are. When they come in here, they go.
No. Talk to him. Why don't you talk to him?
Let's debate. Don't
talk
cry. She's crying now. Are you crying?
So
she's crying now.
Wait.
You see?
Why?
You see? Soko, I'm here to debate. Three Bibles. They're not the same. Not the same.
I am crying there and holding.
He's saying, he's making claim.
Talk to him.
Talk to him. Talk to him.
I'm here. Talk to me. Talk to me.
Quite frankly,
you made a claim. The Bible said, prove all things. 1 Thessalonians 2:21. Your Bible, prove all things. Hatu Burhanakum. You've been cornered. Don't go to the prophets, yeah. They are not prepared to debate with you. Your camera is here. Evil man. I'm here. She can't. I'm a joke. What? Two Qurans. Come on. What are the Qurans?
You're a joke.
I'm a joke. I don't think.
So debate him. Debate him.
I don't think.
What is Bob? I'm here. All of you. I'm here. She can't.
So debate him, guys. Debate him. Are you so scared? Are you scared of him?
She's scared.
He's only a little person. It's not that big.
Small man. Small man. Look at you.
Look,
I know you.
I want someone to.
He's deceiver.
Muslims here who are not prepared to debate with you.
Debate him.
You wet your pants.
Khatun.
What is Bob? Let them come here. Any topic?
Debate him. Why are you scared? Debate him.
We don't claim. I'm here to debate.
You claim your
three Bibles. Okay, what's the Quran?
Please.
You can't debate in secret.
Debate him.
Shame there. They're ashamed. Let's go. They can't debate. When they come here, that's what they go to the brothers who are not prepared to debate and lie about that two Quran, three Quran. You see, I've been there, and she's like, what's she doing? Panicking. Liar they are. That's what they do. So when they come here, they go and look at the Muslims, brothers who are not prepared to debate with them, what they do? They now ask them questions and put them on the spot. Why come with a Bible? They wet their pants because they haven't studied their Bible. I got the Bible, see, they're not the same. Look at here. Come here, that's it. Bro, because something just happened. The incident just happened down there. The incident happened. So my brother, see, they come here. I came to speak as soon as I come in, I saw her too with the brother. They all around him with the cameraman. There are two or three Qurans, you know, with a copy of the Quran. One cannot speak Arabic. You see how crafty they are? This is the eye. Your guys are insipid, you see? I've come here to debate with them. Oh, and they see the Bible. They run away like chicken, hearts and wings. There! Because they don't believe in their Bible. The Quran is only one Quran. 114 surahs, 6,236 verses. No addition, no deletion. But the Bible here, look, they are not the same. Hold it on. The Bible, they are not the same, you see? I'm going to prove to you now. See this Bible here? They are not the same. They are not the same. No, I said they are not the same.
We don't claim the throne. Like you
are. Because what? Look,
same one,
the same one, no change. I told you, no change. Show me. I'm there. Bring a different Quran. Bring the changes. They can't.
We know there are differences.
Read the Bible.
They're not the same. They're not the same.
Read the Bible.
And they're not the same.
Read the Bible, brother.
Because the Bible says that God is not an author of confusion.
Read the Bible.
If God is not an author of confusion. Say that. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse number 3. For God is not. And the way
we
of the Lord is perfect.
We don't need more of abrogation,
yeah?
Brother.
But then,
in the Quran,
these Bibles here, do you know what this one said about this? I want to read so you know.
We
you know.
Claim.
Can you read
that? We
up?
Don't claim that the Bibles are the same. Like you claim that
yeah.
The Quran
is the same. So where is the original
calm
Bible?
Down, Lamin. Calm down, Lamin.
I say,
read something.
We know there are different translations.
What?
We know.
What is the original?
You know why? Because say, God loves you. God loves you. He loves you. God loves you.
See the Bible?
Lamin loves the Bible. Lamin loves the Bible. Get him to read it.
Jesus Christ.
Everybody else hates your guts.
Read the Bible, Lamin.
Jesus Christ. He loves the
Bible. God loves Lamin, but everybody else hates his
guts. I love Jesus Christ.
He loves you.
Yeah, but
he loves Jesus, but he's not God.
So
Jesus is not God.
Jesus
is not God. You shall never be God. Never claim divinity. You believe in Trinity?
Which Jesus do you believe in?
Jesus, who was sent to the children of Israel. He was sent only, said, I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. He never said he was sent to the Gentiles. Never. The Bible's here, show me. And when he sent his disciples.
Jesus, Saint Jesus.
And
Jesus Christ is not
the
Lord. He loves you.
No, we love Jesus. We love Jesus. We revere him.
You
but only Messiah, but not God. But
Bible,
not
you
God incarnate. Is he God?
So you love
the Bible. Well, this guy's got half of
the Bible.
He's upset.
Look, listen to me.
So you love the Jesus Christ loves
you. How is the Son of God?
God loves him. Jesus loves this man.
The Bible says,
I'm sure.
And he loves you. And
you love Jesus, Muslim. What do you mean, Muslim? God loves Jesus.
I can't say.
How did that? He died for me. No, he died for me. How did that? What did I do?
For you. He
how?
Took your sin,
why did?
Your shame.
Okay. What sin?
What sin? You're separated from God because you've broken His laws.
Okay,
talk.
You are covered in shame. You're separated from God. You've broken His laws.
Repent, Lamin. Repent, bro.
You know who said that? Do you know who said that in the Bible? You said Christian. You talk about it in the Bible. You know who said it in the Bible?
Which version is that, bro?
You know,
which version?
No, thank you. He said Jesus died for our sin. What sin have I committed for Jesus to die? You see, Christians are getting this doctrine from Paul. Jesus never said in the Bible that for God so loved the world that he sent into this world to die on the cross of our sins. Jesus never said that because of the sin of Adam and Eve, sin entered into the world. And because of that, God sent into the world to die on the cross of our sins. Never. This is the concept of Paul. That's why Muslims are saying the Christians
something.
Are following Paul. They are following the rest of Paul, not the teaching of Jesus Christ. Paul is the one who came up with this concept of Trinity. If you read the Bible, The only way you see this 3D concept is in the Epistle of Paul. If you read the Bible, it is mentioned in the book of Romans, chapter 5, verse number 12. Paul said, Wherefore as by one man sin entered into the world, and death by sin, and so death passed upon all men, for that all have sinned. Who said that? Paul. Anyone in the Old Testament? No. Paul further says in the book of Romans, chapter 5, verse number 19, that for as by one man,
all the Bible, not
for as by one man, many were made sinners. For as by one man, many were made sinners. According to Paul, Adam and Eve, Adam sinned, and because of that sin, we are all sinners. Furthermore, in the Bible, this is Paul. Paul said, "No Jesus." If you read the Bible, no Jesus. Not God in the Old Testament. This is the invention of Paul. You read the Bible again.
We believe in the New Testament. In the fulfillment book of Jesus Christ.
In the First Corinthians, chapter number 15, verse number 22. Paul said, For in Adam all die. Even so in Christ shall all be made alive. So you can see, because of original sin, it's post invention. Nowhere in the Old Testament you can find this concept. Nowhere in the Old Testament. You see this concept of original sin.
Read the Bible.
But if you read the Old Testament, there are verses which debunks and refuse and confuse this nonsense of the concept of original sin. Let's go to the Old Testament.
Let's go to the New Testament.
If you read the Old Testament,
let's read life and forgiveness. Life and forgiveness.
If you read the Bible, if you read the Bible in the Old Testament, it is mentioned in the book of Ezekiel. They don't go to the Old Testament. In the book of Ezekiel, chapter number 20, verse number 20, says that the soul that sins shall die. The son shall not suffer for the iniquity of the father, nor the father suffer for the iniquity of the son. The righteousness of the righteous shall be upon himself, and the wickedness of the wicked will be upon himself. But if the wicked will turn away from holy sins and of their old bad statutes, and does what is lawful and right, he shall surely live, he shall not die. None of the transgressions which he has committed shall be remembered against him. For the righteousness which I have done, he's a soul in
it. Like he's
the Old Testament said that
reading about the
everyone sins, everyone
he's
sins.
Reading about the servicing, but he doesn't know how to drive the car. Doesn't know how to drive the car.
I debated with this man debunking. Furthermore, in the Bible, several verses debunks this concept of Trinity, the concept of original sin. You read the Bible again, this is mentioned in the book of Deuteronomy, book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 24, verse 16. It says that the fathers shall not be put to death for the children, neither shall the children be put to death for the fathers. Every man shall be put to death for his own sin. Every man shall be put to death for his own sin. So what is this concept of original sin? Furthermore, in the Bible, it is mentioned, see, this same message repeated in the first book of Kings, chapter number 14, verse number 6, that the fathers shall not be put to death for the children. No shall the children be put to death for the fathers, but every man shall be put to death for his own sin. So you can see the Christians are following the teachings of Paul. They are following the rights of Paul, not the teachings of Jesus Christ. Paul is the father of Christianity. Paul is the one who came up with this nonsense of original sin. Nowhere in the Old Testament where God said that because of the sin of Adam and Eve, he sent his begotten son into the world to die on the cross for our sins. It's all nonsense. In the Old Testament, there are verses there which, if you want to have salvation, it speaks about salvation. Forgiveness. Salvation is in the Old Testament. But they do not go to the Old Testament to read the Old Testament. They are blind. If you read the Bible, in the Old Testament, it says that in the book of Isaiah, chapter number 55, verses number 67. 67, seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his ways, and the unrighteous man his thoughts. Let them return to the Lord, that he may have mercy on him. For our God, he will abundantly pardon. The Old Testament says God will abundantly pardon. He will forgive. So where is this concept of original sin? It's all nonsense, all claptrap. You read the Bible again, Old Testament, it is mentioned in Ezekiel, chapter number 18, verse number 30, it says, therefore, for you Israelites, God is talking, therefore, for you Israelites, I will judge you, all of you, according to your ways. repent, turn away from all your sins, so that you can be forgiven. So you can see in the Old Testament, forgiveness is there. God doesn't say anything about blood sacrifice. This is the invention of Paul. Paul, the Antichrist, Paul, the father of Christianity. Furthermore, even in the New Testament, in the book of Acts, chapter 3, verse number 19, say, repent, turn away from all your sins, so that God can forgive you. The Bible is full of Old Testament verses which is telling you, if you sin, you turn to God to forgive you. God says the only savior. So what is this nonsense coming from that Jesus is our savior? You read the Bible. I quoted these verses several times here. In the book of Isaiah, chapter 43, verse number 10, God says, before me no God was formed, nor shall there be any after him. I am the Lord, and besides me there is no savior. God said in the Bible, in the Old Testament, besides him there is no savior. What is the cause of original sin? Furthermore, in the Old Testament, God says in the book of Isaiah, chapter number 45, verses number 21 to 22, says that, and there is no other God besides me. And there is no other God besides me, a righteous God and a savior. There is none besides me. Turn to me and be saved, all the ends of the earth, for I am God and there is no other. God said, turn to him and be saved. He's the only savior. Now you tell me Jesus the savior. Where in the Bible? Show me. This is Paul. Paul is the one coming out with his claptrap, with his nonsense. Even the law. Paul abolished the law. Where in the Bible? You ask the Christian, they say, we live in grace. No, we don't follow the Old Testament laws. Where in the Bible? This is Paul. Paul is the one who came out with the claptrap. You read the Bible again. Let me quote what Paul said about the law. I mean, go what Jesus said. Christian, read your Bible. If you read your Bible, you'll be free. When you come to the Quran, Islam, the last and final testament. This is the word of God, 100%. No addition, no deletion, no errors. But this Bible has got plenty of errors, contradictions, inconsistencies. Let's see what Paul said about the law, and he goes to Jesus and see. Paul is always bashing the law. You read the Bible. Paul said in Galatians, chapter number 2, verse number 16, he said, knowing that a man is not justified by the law, but by faith in Jesus Christ. Even we have believed in Jesus Christ, that we might be justified by the faith of Christ, and not by the works of the law. For by the works of the law shall no flesh be justified. Can you hear that? Where did Paul get that from? When I went to the Old Testament, God never said that. Neither Jesus nor any of the prophets. Furthermore, Paul said in Galatians chapter 2, verse number 21, says that, I do not frustrate the grace of God. For if righteousness come by the law, then Christ died in vain. Amazing. Paul is coming with these concoctions. But where in the Bible? Nowhere. God never said anything in the Old Testament. God never changed his mind. You read the Bible again. Paul said in the book of Romans, chapter number 3, verse number 20, says that, therefore, we conclude that a man is justified by faith in Christ, without the deeds of the law. Paul is passing the law. Law. Killing the law. Furthermore, Paul said in the Bible, in the book of Romans, chapter number 6, chapter number 7, verse number 6, Romans 7, 6, Paul said, by dying for our sins, by Christ dying for our sins, we have been released from the law, so that we live in the new way of the Spirit and not in the old way of the written code. This is nonsensical. Paul found himself. Several verses, Paul is passing the law. That's why they beat him up. They nearly killed him. I'll quote that verse. Paul further says in Galatians chapter number 5, verse number 4, Paul said that you who are trying to be justified by the law have been alienated from Christ. You have fallen away from grace. This is amazing. Where did Paul get that from? Furthermore, Paul went to such extremes that he claimed that Jesus abolished the law in his flesh. You read this in the book of Ephesians, chapter 2, verse 15. Ephesians 2, 15, he said, by abolishing in his flesh the law with his commandments and regulations. So according to Paul, Jesus abolished the law. So let's see what Jesus said about that. my brothers and sisters, read your Bible. Jesus Christ was a Torah observant Jew who never abolished the law, who observed the law and enjoined others to do it. He enjoined disciples and all the others to do so. You read the Bible in, it is mentioned in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 5, verse number 17 to 19. Paul, Jesus said, think not that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. Listen to me. Think not that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come not to abolish them, but to fulfill them. For I tell you, till heaven and earth pass away, not an iota, not a dot will pass from the law until all is accomplished. Whoever then breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches men so shall be called the least in the kingdom of heaven. But he who does them and teaches them shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven. So you can see Paul is the founder of Christianity. Paul is the one who came up with this baloney. You know, that is why they got hold of him in the book of Acts. They nearly killed him. This is mentioned in the book of Acts, chapter number 21, verse number 27, 20. It says that when these 7 days were nearly over, some Jews in the province of Asia saw Paul in the temple. They stirred up the whole crowd, seized him and said, men of Israel, help us, help us. This is the man who teaches all men everywhere against our people and our law and this place. So Paul, as I said, is an antichrist going against the teaching of Jesus Christ. Peace on him. Jesus Christ never abolished the law. Jesus never said that, spoke about anything in any way or shape or form about this concept of original sin. It's Paul's invention, I said. Paul is the one who says that because of sin of Adam and Eve, sin entered into the world. And because of that, you know, we are all sinners. So, because of that, God sent Jesus into the world to die for the sin, this thing, for the atonement of this sin. So my brothers and sisters, as I said, when I came here, I saw a cartoon there, speaking to a brother who is not prepared, who did not come here to debate. And with their cameraman saying that there are two Qurans, and when I pull out the Bibles, she freak out. You see, my brothers, this is the eye. Give up. In fact, you are helping us. When you come here, you attack Islam, you are helping us. You are spreading the message because people are finding out that you are liars. All of this, Bob and the rest, they're all liars. And Allah says a lot about them. If you go to the Quran, Allah said, in Surah Saf, chapter number 61, verse number 6, says that they, that is the disbelievers, intend to put out the light of Allah, but Allah will bring His light to perfection, even though the disbelievers hate it. Even though you hate it, Allah will make this Islam prevail. And He said that in Surah Al-Fath, chapter number 48, verses number 20, says that. He Allah is the one who has sent His messenger with guidance, with the haq and the religion of truth, in order that it may prevail over all religion. And Allah is a witness to this. Allah is a witness to this fact that He will make Islam prevail. And that is happening now. That is exactly what is happening now. The fastest growing religion in the world is Islam. My brother and sister, all we are doing to invite you to the religion of all the prophets is Islam. Islam means submitting your will to Almighty God. Worshipping the Creator, not the creation. The Creator is one alone. The Quran, if you read the Quran in Surah, the Quran as well. Quran has got 140 surahs. Now, the concept of Quran, you go to Surah Al-Ikhlas, the 112th surah. It said, "Kun wallahu ahad." Say is Allah the one. Allahu samad. Allah upon whom all depend. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. He begets not, nor is He begotten. Wa lam yakun lahu kufuwan ahad. And there is nothing unto like Him. If you read the Bible, same day as I said, several verses in the Bible. In fact, in the Bible, God says He's not a man. Hosea 11:9, for I am God, I am not man. God is not a man. God says He's not a man. And Jesus said He's the man. In the Gospel of John 8:40, when the enemies wanted to kill Him, what did He say? But now you seek to kill Me, a man who has told you the truth we heard from God. A man who has told you the truth which I have from God. Here, Jesus makes a distinction between him and Almighty God. So I'm going to end the video here by quoting a verse from the Holy Quran from Surah Al-Imran 364 said, "Kul ya hal kitab, say all people in the book, say all Jews and Christians, ta'ala ila kalimati sawa bena bena kum, that come to common times as we do as and you. Allah na'budu illa Allah. That we worship none but Allah. Wala nusuka bihi shay'an. That we associate no partners with him. Wala yaqtatu ba'duna ba'dan arbaba min duni Allah. That we erect not from among ourselves lords or patrons other than Allah. Fa inta Allah. But if you turn away for kulus hadu, then bear witness we are now Muslimun. That we are Muslims bound to Allah's will. Wa qadawana walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin."